warm good morning to all of you children. Myself, Samuel Prabhakar, principal of Mahan Public School, again welcomes you all back on these online classes. Today we'll continue with Standard 7, Literature. It is the continuation of part 2 of the chapter that we had explained in the previous video, that is the beginning of a new life. I have told you children, in the previous video I had explained to you that actually the beginning of a new life is an extract. This chapter is not a complete story, it is an extract. I have explained to you what is an extract. An extract actually is a short part of a novel, okay, from which it is taken out. So actually the novel's name is David Copperfield, okay, and written by a renowned author, who is the most renowned author but got the laureate in literature, that is Charles Dickens. Okay, so in the previous video, I am giving you a short summary regarding the previous video. In that we had discussed that how David leaves his stepfather's house and fleds away from there to reach his maternal aunt's house. Okay, what kind of problems he faces in his way, and he has to leave his stepfather's house because his stepfather is very cruel. Okay, he has stopped him from going to school. He sends him to work so that he can earn money for him. Okay, so he can't bear that torture anymore, and he leaves his stepfather's house and goes to his maternal aunt's house. Leaves for his maternal aunt, expecting that his maternal aunt would adopt him and provide him a better future. When he reaches his maternal aunt's house, his aunt sees him. First of all, her aunt is shocked. His aunt is shocked to see him. Okay, but after that, he is given a warm welcome by his maternal aunt. Then his stepfather is given a call by his aunt. His stepfather is told that David will stay with his aunt. His aunt told him that David will be adopted by the maternal aunt, and the legal heir, Mr. Dick and aunt, maternal aunt, will be their real legal guardian. So after saying this, the stepfather and the stepmother sister leaves away. Now this is the thing that we have discussed in the previous chapter video. Okay, now let's go to the second part of this part chapter. So now, as I told you, that Mr. Dick, who was very comfortable with David. Now, as Mr. Dick and David start staying together, they develop a very good relation. They soon become good friends. Normally, Mr. Dick was the legal guardian of David, and he used to spend most of the time with David, and both of them often used to have a good time. So, by spending this time together, they ultimately became good friends, and often went out to fly his huge kite. And as we had discussed in the previous video, I have told you that Mr. Dick had a passion for flying kites. Okay, so normally the times that they spent, most of the time were actually flying kites. Okay, so definitely they used to go to the countryside and used to fly these kites and used to spend a lot of time together. I began getting closer to Aunt Betsy too, as David was spending most of the time with Mr. Dick and his Aunt Betsy. So they soon became very familiar with David, and David soon became very loved to them. Okay, David, she said one evening, she means Aunt Betsy. Okay, now one day while David was sitting beside Aunt Betsy, so her aunt asked him, "You must not forget your education, because till now David was not going to school, as we are all aware of. But yes, for a bright future, education is most important, as children you know. Education is the most important to brighten up our future." So his aunt asked him, said, "David, you must not forget your education. You must have something, you must do something regarding your education." After a pause, a short moment of silence, after a pause, she asked me, "Will you be happy if I send you to your school in Canterbury?" Okay, Canterbury, a lot of convent schools are there in Canterbury. Okay, so she asked David, that will you be happy if I send you to a school in Canterbury, especially a boarding school? I replied, I, David, as I told you in the previous video, that this story is told in the form of autobiography. That means here the narrator is David himself. Okay, so wherever I is mentioned, that is referred to David. Okay, so here the narration is done by David himself. So I replied, yes, I certainly would, and it is so near to your home. Canterbury was not very far away from the place where Aunt Betsy lived. So it was very nearby. So he happily agreed, because obviously David also wanted to secure his future. He also wanted a good career. So how could he neglect his education? So he agreed. So it was decided that 2 days later we would go to Canterbury. So it was planned that after 2 days they will move to Canterbury. As we left, my aunt informed me that we would first visit Mr. Wickfield, an old friend of hers. Okay. So as before leaving, my aunt informed me that David's aunt informed him that first of all they would meet Mr. Wickfield then. Okay, and who was Mr. Wickfield? Mr. Wickfield was an old friend of Aunt Betsy. He was the lawyer and steward of the estate. Steward means a European word for manager. Okay? So he was a lawyer and the manager of the estate, okay, of a rich and affluent gentleman of the family. And he was also a very rich and well-known. Affluent means well-renowned. Okay? Affluent. Okay? Renowned person. Okay? Nami Butena, Prasit or Nami. So he was the lawyer and the steward, that is manager, of the estates of the rich and affluent gentlemen of the country. So when we reached Mr. Wickfield's office, we were welcomed by a man called Korea Lee. Okay, Korea Lee was a man who used to look after Mr. Wickfield's office and home as well. So he guided us to the room where Mr. Wickfield was present. Well, Miss Trotwood, okay, Aunt Spencer's name was Miss Trotwood, okay, so he summoned my aunt in that way. Well, Miss Trotwood, what brings you here? What brings you here? That means, what is the reason for your visit? So what brings you here? Mr. Wickfield inquired. My aunt replied, I wish you to draw adoption papers for my nephew David here. Actually, Aunt Betsy has a legal work also, because I have told you that legally Aunt Betsy was adopting David. Adoption means what? Both of them. Okay? Kisi bhi bache ko apne parivar ka sadasya banana by inhit legal way. Okay, that is, this legal procedure is called adoption. Okay? So that's why she wanted to prepare the papers regarding the adoption. Okay? And as you know that Mr. Wickfield was a lawyer also. So my aunt replied, I wish to draw up adoption papers for my nephew David here. In fact, he is my grand nephew. Okay, he introduced David that in fact he is my grand nephew. Okay, that means sister's son. I also want advice on a school in Canterbury. Okay, and I also want your advice or help in the admission in Canterbury, where David could be taught well and treated well. So I want such a school where David could be taught well, treated well, and much attention should be given on him, because as we all know that David was not a regular student. From childhood onward, David had not gone to school, because I have told you in the previous video that his aunt, that his stepfather had never sent him to school. Instead of sending him to school, he had sent him to work in order to earn money. Okay, so David had no idea of education. So that's why Aunt Betsy wanted such a school which could guide David in a proper way, okay, so that David could be taught well and treated well. Mr. Wickfield thought for a moment and said, because David was a special kid, so that's why Mr. Wickfield thought for a moment and then said, the best school in the district does not have any rooms for boarders. Okay, I have a best school, but the problem is that the boarders mean those who live in a boarding means hostel, jahan bachche rehkar padha vidya grahan karte hain, hostel. So border means jo boarding mein rehte hain unko boarders kehte hain. Okay, so the best school is here. I have a good school, but now at present there are no room vacant for boarders now. Okay, boarding pura bhar chuka hai, abhi boarding mein koi jagah khali nahi hai. But agar aap chahe to you may leave him with me, lekin agar aap ki chahe ga, agar aapki marzi ho to aap use yahan chhod sakte hain. It was so helpful, say Mr. Wickfield. Okay, you may leave him with me. till further arrangements are made. Until then, the boarding is vacant, or if I get any kind of vacancy in the boarding, until then, if you have no problem, Mr. David, David can live with me in my house. Mr. Wickfield called for his housekeeper. Housekeeper means a person who maintains the whole house, okay, including grocery, kitchen, all the things regarding the house. He or she is called a housekeeper, okay. So Mr. Wickfield called for his housekeeper, and the housekeeper was none other who turned out to be a little girl of mine. The housekeeper was just a little girl of David's age only, okay. How many of David's age, okay. So that housekeeper was a little girl of David's age only. Mr. Wickfield told us, Mr. Wickfield introduced us to her. Actually, her name was Agnes, and she was his daughter, and she was none other than Mr. Wickfield's daughter. So that means Mr. Wickfield's daughter, in this tender age only, was maintaining the whole house for Mr. Wickfield. So by this we come to know that how much mature she was at this age. Okay? So later, Agnes told me that she had lost her mother when she was born. Agnes considered it her duty to stay at home and keep house for her father. So Agnes, when she started talking with David, so she introduced her, she tried to share her feelings. So she told that her mother was expired or died when she was born. So Agnes took up the duty to maintain the home and keep her father comfortable. Okay? While my aunt prepared to leave, now it was time David's aunt started to leave. She said, but before leaving, she advised David. Now David, never be mean in anything. Usne advice diya, jaane ke pehle aapne kya advice diya? First of all, she told David not to be selfish, mean. Okay, sirf apne baare mein nahi bolna. Never be mean in anything. Never be cruel. Cruel nahi banna hai. Dil mein daya ki bhavna rakhi. And never be false or jhoota nahi. Okay, we should never be false in our acts or thoughts. And these were the three advices that she had. Never be mean, never be cruel, and never be false. So these were the three advices that she gave David before David. I can always be hopeful of you. And if you follow these three things, that if you are not mean, if you are not cruel, and if you are not false, you will never divert from your way and your goal will be clear. And I am expecting the same from you. And go kaafi umeedein thi David se. Okay, so she told her that I have lot of expectation from you, and I know that you will stand up to my expectation. Okay, और आपको यकीन था कि जो भी उम्मीदें थी, David उनको खड़ा उतरेगा. Mr. Wickfield's house was present and peaceful. Now, the experience in Mr. Wickfield's house. Mr. Wickfield's house was obviously probably very pleasant and peaceful because only two members were there and one housekeeper. Okay, Mr. Wickfield, her daughter, and one housekeeper. Okay. After dinner, Agnes played the piano. After dinner, Agnes normally used to have the habit of playing the piano. Okay, piano, a musical instrument you must have seen in the pictures. Okay, and I could see how devoted she was to her father. And in the meantime, David could observe that Agnes, how much devotion she had towards her father. That means how much keen she was in serving her father. Okay, so this shows her that Agnes, as she was, as I mentioned, that she was of David's age only, but she was quite mature then. Okay, at this tender age, she was not only maintaining the house, but she was also maintaining and looking after her father's needs. Okay. Now, the next morning, Mr. Wickfield took me to my new school. He introduced me to Dr. Strong, the headmaster of the school. The head boy Adams and the principal, introduced me to the head boy Adams and showed me round and introduced me to the masters. And Adams took me around the classroom and he introduced me to the class teachers of various classes. Okay, as normally, like the formality, whenever a new teacher or new program, he introduced all the teachers. Now, I was quite at ease. David was not at all uncomfortable. David was quite at ease because school had a friendly environment, but very conscious of the difference in learning. But David had a problem because the difference in learning, because as I mentioned to you, David was not a regular student, because from childhood David had no experience of going to school. Okay, because his stepfather had never sent him to school. So going to school obviously was a good experience, but After seeing the other students, David came to know that he had to work very hard to meet the expectations of his aunt. Okay? So, but yet David was not at all troubled because he had that courage and he had a dream. Because we know, because when we have a dream or when we have an ambition, so nothing can stop us. So David had that ambition of doing something in the future. Okay? So that evening, Mr. Wickfield asked me again if I thought I should like to stay with them. Okay. So that time, Mr. Wickfield again, he came to me and asked me that, are you comfortable in my house? And if he would like to continue to live there. So I told him that, okay, I was very comfortable in his house and I would like to continue in his house. On the way out to school the morning, I encountered Uriyami sweeping the steps outside. Uriyami was the office in charge of Mr. Wickfield. So at that time, what she was doing, she was sweeping the steps outside the house. So she wished me as normally, good morning, Mr. Master Copperfield. I trust you will have a good day at school. I hope. Okay. She expected what? That I hope you will have a good day at school. Thank you, Uriya. And I hope you will have a good day with your studies in law. And we also, normally when somebody greets us, we also greet them. So David also wished her that what? That I hope you will have a good day with your studies in law. Studies in law, lawyer. Okay, one who studies law. I suppose you are quite a lawyer because he was working in Mr. Wickfield's office. So David thought that as he was working in Mr. Wickfield's office and Mr. Wickfield was a professional lawyer, so Uriya must have learned some laws and she must be quite a bit of lawyer. Me, Master Copperfield. But when he told her this sentence, she asked in surprise, me, Master Copperfield? Oh no, I am a very humble person. I am well aware that I am the humblest person going. Let the other be where he may. Okay? Likewise, my mother is a very humble person. We live in humble abode. Okay? So by these words, actually, Uriya told that whatever she was happy with it and she didn't want to expect anything more beyond that. Okay? And she wants to be humble towards her master. So Master Copperfield, but have much to be thankful for. Okay? And she told that Mr. Wickfield had been very kind to him and she had much to thank for her. Have you been with Mr. Wickfield for long? I asked. David asked, that have you been living with Mr. Wickfield for a long time? Going on 4 years. Ye chautha saal hai. It is the continuation of 4 years. Master, Copperfield, since a year after my death of my father, I have started staying here since the death of my father and now it is the continuation of the 4th year. That day, I reached school quite early, the first day of the school. In about 2 weeks, I was very contented there. And in the 2 weeks only, David adjusted himself quite comfortably in the school. I was not skillful in their games and quite backward in the study. Though David was not up to the mark either in games or either in studies. But practice would improve me in the first. But David knew that practice makes a man perfect. Okay, that is a problem. Very popular saying, okay? If you practice, kal tak abhyas jagat ko sujan, humne padha hai Hindi mein, kahavat hai. So practice makes a man perfect, okay? There is nothing that you can't achieve. By practice, you can achieve anything. So David had that thing in mind, that if he go on with the continuous practice, he can improve in his games as well as in his studies. I worked and hard work in the second. Fortunately, I proved myself in both. As David worked sincerely, he proved in just in a month or two, David proved his teachers as well as his aunt that he was improvement or showing improvement in games as well as studies. And this all was due to what? Due to dedication, the utmost dedication he had. Every third or fourth week, I visited Aunt Betsy, Joni in Dover. Dover was the place where Aunt Betsy lived. And on alternate Wednesdays, alternate arrangement, one, giving one is Wednesday and the next Wednesday, okay? The alternate Wednesday, Mr. Dick would visit me. Mr. Dick befriended Dr. Strong and he became a popular figure at school. Life at Wickfield home was quiet and peaceful and David had adjusted completely there. To my great comfort, Henry became more of a sister to me. Henry, who was my caretaker, now the affection had appeared between them so much that now she was just like a sister to me, that even Aunt Betsy could have ever imagined. Hence my life at Canterbury was a happy and prosperous one. So in this way, the Davids, as we have seen the extract, what is the extract? The beginning of a new life. So in this way, David's new life started. And this is the, as I told you, this is a small short extract from this novel. And this novel continues so on. Actually, it is the this novel includes the whole journey of David, that how David does his schooling, how he does his university, and after that, how he builds up his career and how he becomes a millionaire. Okay, this whole story is about that. Okay, it is actually a journey of a person. Okay, and it is very well written by Charles Dickens. Okay, one of the renowned authors who has got the laureate in literature. Okay, so if you have time, you can get this book from the library and you can read it. Okay, so I hope, children, the chapter is clear to you. Now let's go for the word drill. Okay, I am giving you some word drill. You can note it down. Okay, I am giving you some words which you can just note down. Okay, let's pronounce that word first. Go for it. First, steward, a new word. What is the meaning of steward? Steward means manager. Okay, one who manages. Estate. Estate, what is the meaning of estate? A large area of plantation. Okay, you know, we have learned about plantation, I think. A large area of plantation, either tea, coffee, rubber, such kind of vast area is called an estate. Affluent. Affluent means renowned. Okay, a nami. That's it. Affluent. Affluent means renowned. Then adoption. Adoption means what? To take somebody or to make somebody, some child, a member of your former family in a legal way. इसको हम लोग हिंदी में हम लोग वोट देना कहते हैं. तो एडॉप्शन एक्चुअली एक लीगल मेथड है जिसमें हम किसी भी बच्चे को अपने परिवार का सदस्य बनाते हैं कानूनन रूप में. ओके, सो दिस प्रोसीजर इज कॉल्ड एडॉप्शन. ओके, देन आई एम गोइंग थ्रू दैट वर्ड्स ओनली व्हिच आर न्यू वर्ड्स फॉर यू. अच्छा, वाइसेस. वाइसेस मींस एडवाइस, इट इज शॉर्ट ऑफ एडवाइस. Okay, wisest means advice. Conscious. Conscious means aware of. Okay, known of or aware of. Then fortunately, luckily. And at ease means at comfort. Okay, I hope, children, you have understood these words. But still, if you have any word that you are not understanding, you can underline that word or you can just type it and you can consult me on my Telegram account. So this explanation is done. Both the part I have done the explanation. Keep your books aside while going through the video. In the next class, I will do the notes regarding to chapter part 1 and part 2. Okay? Till then, goodbye. Have a good day.